All right, so contractor called. I guess we have a buried oil tank at this house. They cleared away a bunch of crap in the back, and now we have a buried oil tank to deal with. So let's go check it out.
All right, we're coming along. We're making some progress on the inside.
I think he's way slow.
It is slow, but we've had sub issues and inspection issues and all sorts of stuff. So yeah.
All right, let's check out and see where the septic, where they said they found the septic out back. Here she be. So, buried oil tank. Well, what do you do? When there's oil in it, let's see. This ought to smell great.
I'm glad it's you and not me.
Do you have a match? Ironically, we put a new septic system here. I mean, we got the pipeline over there. We already put a new septic in. It's a shame because we already had a machine back here. I don't know how they got the machine back here. Let me call Nick. Let me see what we can do.
Hi, Glenn.
I said, how's my favorite excavator doing today?
All right.
I'm buttering you up. So listen, I have got we found a buried oil tank at our house here in Rotterdam. So I've got to get it out. The challenge I've got is, I don't know how you're gonna get a machine back here. What do you have for machinery to get back here? And do you have to have a machine to get back here? How are you gonna take it out?
Well, how wide?
How wide
do we have to get back there?
What do you think?
I need 5 feet to get it.
All right, so if we trim it back, we can get you back. You got the Bobcat?
Yeah, it's Bobcat with the back line. It's 5 feet wide.
Okay.
And what size is the tank?
So I don't know. It's buried. I got the fill line and the vent line sticking out of the top. I really don't know.
So it's probably gonna, if you've got tight quarters getting in and out, we'll probably have to cut it up back there. Does it have any oil in it?
I do see some oil on the bottom, yeah. You have to pump it out?
Yeah, we can pump it out. That's not a problem.
Okay.
I just gotta come and stick it and see how much is in it. I mean, if it's a couple inches, it's not gonna matter.
Maybe I can sell the oil back to you. What's it going rate for oil these days? What do you think price-wise get this taken out of here? Because this is not something we expected. What do you think?
Well, it's going to be around like $2,500.
You're killing me.
My time.
I'm your favorite.
No,
I'm your favorite.
I know you're my favorite.
Nick, I'm here too. Does that help?
Okay, Amber.
You think we can
cut? Where is it? It's in Rotterdam, you said?
It is in Rotterdam, so it's all sand. Yep. You think we can get under two on it?
Where is it?
It's also over under Forest.
Better. You can do it for two.
Two? All right.
For you, I probably can do it for two.
All right.
There might be complications. If it goes easy, you know, I'll take care of you. You know that.
I know. All right, cool. How soon can you get it out of here?
Tomorrow? This week, I know that. No, it ain't going to happen tomorrow.
All right. Well, hopefully soon.
You got to come. Yeah, it'll be soon, okay? I mean, I'll put it in.
Okay.
I'll squeeze it in there. I got a couple jobs going.
All right, cool.
But I can squeeze a day out, you know?
All right, we're trying to wrap this job up so good. All right, cool. All right, brother, I appreciate the help.
All right, have Youll call me.
I will.
Okay.
Thanks, man.
Nick.
Talk all right,
bye.
To you later.
All right, bye. All right, so the value of having great relationships is that if you have a guy that does your excavation work, you can actually give them a call and have that taken out. You don't have to go make it too complicated. It's not, again, if we have fluid in there, it's not rotting to the bottom more than likely. That's when it can cause a problem with the EPA and kind of serious if there's stuff leaking through. But have a guy come out. If there's permits required, he'll take care of all that. I don't think they require it here, actually. I don't know what they do, but if they do, he'll have to get that. We'll take that out of there, put dirt in there, and we're good to go. So we weren't expecting to spend $2,000.
So now you're going to come to me and ask me to shave $2,500 out of my interior budget.
No, I'm
budget,
not.
Aren't
I'm going to ask you to shave $2,000 because I got them down $500. So we got
$2,000.
So now if we can try to shave money off the budget someplace, that's a lot of money to shave off, but what can we do? And I think we bought this one right, so we got room in it, so I think we're okay.
Yeah, I'll have to make a few adjustments here and there, but we'll see what we can do.
So the bottom line is, guys, when you're flipping a house, things come up, and we always figure an oops factor in our home flipping checklist that we do. We always figure a 10% of our budget for an oops factor. This is gonna eat up a lot of that oops factor, but at least we already have it figured into the budget.
I just came up with our solution.
I'm listening.
I'm staring right at it. So follow me over here. So we were originally going to repair this deck, and then we were gonna replace this deck, and now I think we repair it again. But that was our original plan, was to take this part of it off, make this the end of the deck, and then we'll power wash that, get all this old paint off, and then we'll refinish it, and it'll look like a brand new deck.
What's that new covering you put on the deck?
Yeah, it's a Bear product, and we did it on a house recently, and it turned out really, really good. So there you go.
Good, problem solved. All right, guys, that's it. You're gonna have problems on houses. Just make sure you buy them right to begin with, so when a problem does come up, you've got room to get through it. And you have a good designer that can fix stuff. And when you lose $2,000 here, you can find $2,000 over here. Hey, good job, babe. All right, talk to you.